Can you tell me what is a trapezium according to you?
So I think a trapezium is one where there are four sides and two of them, so like two sides are parallel and two sides aren't parallel.
Okay.
Two opposites.
So can I say it like one pair of sides are parallel? So for being a parallel, it has to be opposites, and so no need to say that. Is it fine?
Yes.
One pair. When you are saying an out of four, two. So we know that trapezium is a quadrilateral, hence only one pair. Is it fine? One pair of opposite sides. One pair, no? So is parallel. So how does it look like? That is more important. So that's the only property, or is there any other property for a trapezium?
So if the only one pair of sides is parallel, I don't think the diagonals will bisect the pairs.
So some of the figures which are famous is this one. So this side is parallel, and it can be reverse also. Okay, this side is also parallel. Is it fine? Can you see one pair is parallel?
Yes, sir.
So these are some of the figures which you will be able to see around you or in math note textbooks. So when there is one pair parallel, it becomes trapezium. Okay. At times, I'm just extending it for you. At times, what happen? They give you one more information that the non-parallel sides are equal. So that kind of trapezium become isosceles trapezium. Is this thing clear?
Yes, sir.
So the term isosceles trapezium means one pair of sides parallel. Other pair, not the same, other pair of sides is equal. Is this thing clear? If it becomes same, what if I take a line which is parallel and equal? So this line, let's say 5 centimeter, and this line is 5 centimeter, and both are equal. Okay, both are equal, and if I join the points, what do you think, what figure will be formed? Very good. So here the parallelogram becomes. So what was the information I gave? This side was parallel and this side was equal. So if one pair of sides is parallel and equal, try to understand this thing. Try to understand this thing. Same side I'm talking about. Here, I'm not talking about the same side. I'm talking about this side is parallel and these two sides are equal. Okay, give me a minute. Hold on. So I hope you understood the major difference between isosceles trapezium and parallelogram. And this property of parallelogram is very important. Okay. So again, I'm just restating. One pair of side is parallel, other pair is equal. Here, one pair of side is parallel and equal. That means I'm talking about this only. So that will give me a parallelogram. I hope you have seen. If I take any side, no, I'll draw one line. Let's say I'm able to copy this line exactly, let's say 5 centimeter. I can draw anywhere, wherever you want. I can draw down, I can draw up, side, okay? But it has to be parallel. So what will happen, the figure which will be drawn after joining the points will be parallelogram. Right now, I don't have a scale on this online medium. So that's why it is not looking exactly, but I hope you will be trying this thing of your own. Okay, I hope you have copied. Should I move ahead in understanding exactly what is a parallelogram? So our next heading comes parallelogram. That earlier what I did, I just told you a simple definition of a parallelogram. Now what we are going to do, understand in detail all the properties of a parallelogram. Yeah, Sana, can you tell me what are the properties of a parallelogram?
Yeah, so both opposite sides are parallel.
Opposite sides are parallel. How do we say that? We mark it like this, arrows. Remember this thing. So this side is parallel to this side, and this side is parallel to this side. And if in a question they give you a figure and mark it like this, that means these two sides are parallel without, even if they don't write this thing. Is this thing clear?
The opposite angles are equal.
So there is one more property related to sides. Opposite sides are equal also. This side is equal to this. This side is equal to this.
Yeah.
Aaron, can you tell me another property?
One pair, so I know that, so they're equal and they're also parallel.
Okay, what you can do right now, just go and check the figure, the sheet which I gave you, remember? The sheet which I gave you.
In yes, that sir, sheet, just check. Yeah.
Check which is a parallelogram and what according to you are the properties.
I meant it in that way.
So A, B, C, D. So A will be equals to C and this will be equal to this. That what you are saying?
Yes, sir, that was what I meant to say.
So this is not called alternate, this is called opposite. You can say alternate.
Yes, opposite angle. Yes, opposite angles.
So opposite angles are equal. So basically in a quadrilateral, three things are there. One is side, one is angle, another is diagonal. So you have told me from side perspective, you have told me from angle perspective. Now let us look at from diagonal perspective. Okay. So can you tell me a property? First of all, what do you think? Diagonals are equal?
Diagonals are
they're not, because one diagonal will be longer than the other.
Yes. They are not equal. Can you see this point is very far from this point and this point is very close to this point? By looking at it also, we can see that. You can also measure. Now, if diagonals are not equal, what else? Are diagonals bisect each other? What do I mean by that?
Yes.
This bisect has a like, it'll be equal like the halfway until from the point till the halfway point. It'll be equal to
two equal parts. Isn't it? So what do we mean by that? Is AO equals to OC and BO equals to OD. So yes, that is true. You can measure that thing. Diagonals bisect each other. I hope you are drawing the figures also.
Yes, sir.
Another thing. So in a diagonal, there are three things which we look. First thing we look at, are they equal? Are they bisecting? And are they at 90 degree or not? Okay. And in sides, we look at parallel and equal. Okay. That's how we classify all the properties. Now, quickly tell me, are the diagonals at 90 degree? What do we mean by that?
No, sir, they aren't. They'll be obtuse and acute, but they won't be 90 degree.
So this angle will not be equal to this angle, no?
Yeah.
Definitely not. So no. So we will not write that. So these are the four properties of a parallelogram. I hope it is clear.
Yeah, so then what are alternate angles if those are opposite angles?
No, opposite angle is same alternate angles.
Okay.
Alternate angle, what you are saying is absolutely correct. So if you are standing here, alternate means this one.
Okay.
Alternate means one after, like leaving one person in between. So you are right in that way. But in while writing the properties, while using the properties, we don't use alternate word. We can use opposite angles are equal. Done? Note it down?
Yeah.
Should I move ahead? Next one. Now, if in a parallelogram, just look carefully. This line becomes like this. It becomes a, what shape is it is taking?
It's a rectangle.
Rectangle.
I mean, yeah, wait.
So parallelogram is turn into a rectangle. Okay, we have done in the last class. So in a rectangle, all the properties of parallelogram are there. Remember that. Parallel sides, equal sides, equal angles. But a special case, opposite angles are equal. In this case, all angles are equal to 90 degree, isn't it? In this case, rectangle, diagonals are also equal, isn't it?
Yes.
and diagonal bisect also. When I say all the properties are included here, I mean it. Can you see that? Opposite sides are parallel, which is here. Opposite sides are equal, which is here. Opposite angles are equal, which is here. Isn't it? Opposite angles are equal. They are 90. And diagonal bisect each other. So diagonal bisect each other. So that's how you remember. You want to copy this part? Or no need, you have that.
I've copied.
Now, earlier we were at a quadrilateral. Just try to see. We were at a quadrilateral. Once two sides become parallel, it became a?
It became a trapezium.
When both the sides become parallel,
parallelogram.
Isn't it? Now, yes. As soon as the angles turn into 90, it becomes a rectangle. Is it making sense?
So, if the first one was just a quadrilateral, right? Like no.
Yeah.
Okay.
It was just a quadrilateral. There was no property. There were four sides and four angles. We don't know whether they are equal. We don't know whether they are 90 degree or what. So, according to me, they are unequal. No two sides are parallel. No two sides are equal. As soon as opposite side become parallel, it turn into a trapezium. As soon as other pair also become parallel, it turn into a parallelogram. Is it fine? As soon as the angles turn into 90 degree, it turns into a rectangle. Now, just observe. From here to here, we are talking about parallel sides. From here to here, I'm talking about parallel sides. From here to here, I'm talking about angle 90. Isn't it? What thing is left? What thing is left? We have not talked about one thing. Always remember, there are three things. Sides and diagonals. We have not talked about sides equality.
Okay.
Yeah, and diagonal also. And diagonal also, Aaron. Okay. Sides equality. So what if a rectangle sides become equal? What will happen to that figure? Isn't it? If I start cutting this thing like this, it will turn into a square. Is it making sense? Yes, no, Aaron?
Yes, sir, it is. I understand.
Okay. So what I was trying to say, that from a quadrilateral, it turned into a trapezium. From trapezium, it turned into a parallelogram. From parallelogram, it turned into a rectangle. Now, when all sides are equal, the rectangle turns into a square. So that is the extra information. Rest all the information are from rectangle. Is this thing clear? So, in a square, all sides are equal. Opposite sides are parallel. Okay. All angles equal to 90 degree. Isn't it? This was in rectangle, this was in rectangle. Yes, no? Diagonals are equal in a square.
Yes, because they're equal in a rectangle.
Diagonal bisect each other.
Yeah, because the sides will be equal.
Yeah. There is one more thing. Diagonals at 90 degrees. That means diagonals are perpendicular. Okay. What do I mean by that? When I take a square, okay, so the line connecting the opposite point so the angle formed over here is always at 90. Is this thing clear?
Yes.
So opposite sides are parallel as they were in parallelogram. All sides are equal. That is a special condition. Diagonal bisect each other and diagonals are equal. Hence, all the points are equal. So what do I mean by that? Parallel. AB is parallel to DC and DA is parallel to BC. This is for parallel. All sides are equal. AB equals to BC equals to CD equals to DA. All four sides are equal. Angle. Angle A equals to angle B equals to angle C equals to angle D equals to 90 degrees. So diagonals are equal. AC equals to BD. Diagonals bisect each other. DO equals to OB. DO equals to OB. And AO equals to OC. One more thing. Let's say this value is 10. What will be the value of AC? Quickly, Aaron. If DC is if DC, DB is 10, then what is the value of AC?
If DB is 10, so that means so this is a square, so it'll be equal. So that's also 10.
Then,
then
what will be the value of DO?
DO will be 5 because the full thing.
What will be the value of BO?
5.
What will be the value of AO?
5.
What will be the value of OC?
5.
Do you understand?
Yes.
So that's why all four are equal. AO equals to OB equals to AO equals to OC. DO equals to OB equals to AO equals to OC. Is that fine? Why they are equal? Any doubt in this? One last property. Diagonals are perpendicular. What do I mean by that? AC is perpendicular. This symbol is for perpendicular to PD. BD, sorry, which means that angle O equals 90 degrees. Where they are meeting, this diagonal and this diagonal is meeting at O. So angle O is 90 degrees. Is this thing fine? So these are the properties of a square. What I have written, all sides are equal. Opposite side parallel, all angle 90, diagonals are equal, diagonal bisect each other, diagonals at 90, that means perpendicular. So So that was just an example. Since it is coming from a rectangle, so it comes down. Okay. Any doubt in this? Any doubt? Yes, no. From here to here, Sana, what thing changed? Angles. I guess I was focusing on angles. I know diagonals must be changed also.
Yeah, the angle changed.
From here to here, what thing changed?
There.
I'm not talking from diagonal perspective right now. Sides were equal. Isn't it?
Yeah.
What if I reverse the order? From parallelogram, if I make sides equal. So what will happen? It will look like a parallelogram. Like this, isn't it? Similar to a square, but not a square. Do you know what is the name of this figure?
Yeah,
is it making sense?
Yeah.
If sides are equal, but angles are not 90. From here to here, angles 90. Okay. So if I talk about rhombus, so rhombus is just like a square. But the problem is the angles are not 90. Or I would say rhombus is just like a parallelogram where the sides are equal. Okay. So all the properties of parallelogram. Opposite sides are parallel. Okay. All sides are equal. Okay, I'll just share this video with you later on so that upload this video and I'll share it with you so that you can revise all the things. Make notes. Is this thing fine?
Yes, sir.
All sides are equal. In a parallelogram, are the diagonals equal? Yeah, Aaron. In a parallelogram, are the diagonals equal?
The diagonals won't be equal.
Won't be equal. Okay. Diagonal bisect each other?
No. Because they're not equal, so how can they bisect?
Are you sure? In a parallelogram, diagonal bisect each other.
So can you draw it? Wait, right, it's wrong. Yeah, so I think it'll bisect.
I think it should bisect. Can you see that?
Yeah, it would bisect.
Diagonal bisect each other. And diagonals are at 90 degree. Are at perpendicular. Are perpendicular. Is this thing clear? This is regarding rhombus. And from rhombus, if you want to enter square, it will be, angle should be 90 degree. So this particular flow chart is very, 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 very important. If you understand this flow chart, you understand all the quadrilaterals. Okay, this is the ultimate.
So I've made this in my notebook.